Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. This video we have a whole load of updates to cover to do with SpaceX with a variety of information. We also have a few but not a huge amount of Boca Chica and Starship updates to look at. Let's head straight in and get up to date. NASA Commercial Crew posted a tweet saying the flight readiness review for the Crew 1 mission to the space station has concluded and NASA and SpaceX are go to proceed with launch on November 14th. Liftoff is currently expected for 12:49 AM UTC or 7:49 PM EDT. SpaceX tweeted a bunch of cool shots of Crew Dragon Resilience and Falcon 9 integrated in the hangar at the pad. Somebody posted a tweet saying that the other boosters in the hangar are B-1049, B-1051 and B-1058, 1058 being for CRS-21. After integration, SpaceX rolled the rocket out to the pad, also sharing some cool shots of the vehicle vertical on LC-39A. Whilst not directly related to SpaceX, Jim Bridenstine will be stepping down from his role as NASA administrator. Apparently, even if asked by the president-elect Biden administration to stay, he will pass. Eric Berger posted a tweet saying, "New report finds the Lunar Gateway likely will not be in a position to support a 2024 lunar landing." Which is okay because there won't be a 2024 lunar landing. Will be interesting to see if Gateway survives the transition. He then also tweeted, "If you are looking at this from SpaceX's perspective, you are definitely on Team Gateway. SpaceX has as much as $7 billion riding on logistics delivery, only about $300,000 of this contract has been paid so far, as well as launching initial elements of the Gateway itself." The US Department of Defense posted some contracts which include SpaceX. The post says SpaceX has been awarded $29.6 million in firm fixed price task orders under the National Security Space Launch Phase 2 contract. We now have a few Boca Chica updates to look at, starting with this view of the orbital launch mount being constructed. They seem to have attached cameras to one of the legs. Mary also captured this awesome shot of the launch pad area from a bit further away than usual. Over on the other side of the facility, there was a new arrival at the old Gaswell lot with this new piece of equipment. This is interesting, a metal panel was seen which says Integration Team Training Panel, so when SpaceX hires new people they don't go messing up any new Starships. We have a bunch of Starship stuff to take a look at. First, we have a tweet from Eric Berger about a newly posted article from NASA. He says, "Interesting, small new grants from NASA announced today. They include funds to Blue Origin for a space robot operating system, Phase 4 for electrical propulsion and SpaceX for Starship re-entry heating data." Everyday Astronaut tweeted asking Musk about his gut feeling on Starship being able to fulfill the goal of full and rapid reusability. Also saying, "I still have such a hard time imagining a booster landing being picked up, refueled and launched again on next orbit." Musk responded with, "I'm hoping to change booster design to land back on launch mount with no legs, will require extreme precision." Elon Musk responded to somebody's animation of Starship re-entering the atmosphere and landing. He said, "There's no entry or braking burn and hypersonic angle of attack is approximately 70 degrees. In response, Scott Manley asked, "With a 70 degree angle of attack, how much cross range does it have? Will it be enough to ensure at least one landing opportunity per day?" Musk said, "Probably." Michael Sheets tweeted about something Gwynne Shotwell said, which was, "The company has looked at the space tug part of the launch market, also known as orbital transfer vehicles," adding she's really excited about Starship to be able to do this, as it's the perfect market opportunity for Starship. Shotwell also said, "With missions increasingly including small satellites, it's going to be very important to come up with the ability to have multiple node crossings on a single launch. And we can do that to some extent with Falcon 9, it's kind of a beast of a rocket." In the production area of the facility, SpaceX recently took delivery of another Raptor engine, this is serial number 42. "We recently saw a new thrust puck with a different design and nearby there are some new aerosurface covers. We have some bits of Starship spotted under construction with a couple of nose cones seen being worked on in the fabrication tent. It appears that this nose in front may get some canard soon. On Monday, SpaceX got quite far into the testing window and appeared to be getting ready for a static fire with SN8. The prototype was seen detanking, and with pretty much no time left in the window, there was no static fire test. It's believed this could have just been a wet dress rehearsal. On Tuesday, the road closed and the pad cleared during the day, and towards the late afternoon, SpaceX appeared to have aborted their first static fire attempt. Their second attempt, on the other hand, definitely happened but didn't look entirely nominal. This second static fire was the first to utilise the nose cone liquid oxygen header tank, and they lit just one engine. Just a quick look at the road and beach closures from Cameron County, there's been a slight change to the dates. With the static fire happening last night, they've cancelled today's testing with more dates on Thursday 12th and Friday 13th. Here's the latest view of the SN9 Starship prototype continuing to be worked on in the high bay. We have some really cool news with the first super heavy booster ring stack being moved over to the high bay. It was then lifted and placed inside the structure alongside Starship SN9. Then another barrel section was rolled over to the high bay from the collection of ring stacks. Subsequently, this stack was also lifted and moved into the high bay ready to be stacked. Finally, whilst it's not entirely the latest build, here's the latest diagram from Brendan Lewis containing the sections known for Super Heavy. As always, I have to thank the incredible Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, who goes out and films all day every day. Behind the scenes and also hosting lengthy live streams of the NASA spaceflight team, thanks to them also. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.